Greetings in the name of our risen Savior, Jesus Christ, and welcome to Sunday morning at Crawford Street. My name is Kevin Bradley, and I'm the pastor here at Crawford Street United Methodist Church in Vicksburg, Mississippi. I'm glad you're with us this morning as we gather together to worship the living God. I invite you to join with me to become still and quiet as we go to God in prayer. Our God of all times and all places, we give thanks for this day that you have given us. We give thanks for your call upon our lives to be your people. O God, as we gather in new and different ways in this very moment, we give thanks, thanks for your holy presence in our midst. Oh God, we continue to journey in this season that is unlike any we have experienced before. We pray for a world that is hurting. We pray for healing. We pray for the healing of bodies and minds and spirits. We seek, O God, we claim the power of your healing, and we cherish and take comfort in the gift of your holy presence. O God, hear our prayer. As together now we lift our voices as one in that prayer that you taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Hear these words from the psalmist. I thank you that you have answered me and have become my salvation. The stone that the builders rejected has become the chief cornerstone. This is the Lord's doing. It is marvelous in our eyes. A reading from the Gospel according to St. Matthew. Listen to another parable. There was a landowner who planted a vineyard, put a fence around it, dug a wine press in it, and built a watchtower. Then he leased it to tenants and went to another country. When the harvest time had come, he sent his slaves to the tenants to collect his produce. But the tenants seized his slave and beat one, killed another, and stoned another. Again he sent other slaves, more than the first, and they treated them in the same way. Finally, he sent his son to them, saying, "They will respect my son." But when the tenants saw the son, they said to themselves, "This is the heir. Come, let us kill him and get his inheritance." So they seized him, threw him out of the vineyard, and killed him. Now when the owner of the vineyard comes, what will he do to those tenants? They said to him, "He will put those wretches to a miserable death and lease the vineyard to other tenants who will give him the produce at the harvest time." Jesus said to them, "Have you never read in the Scriptures? The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. This was the Lord's doing, and it is amazing in our eyes."I have veered from the appointed text for this week. Instead, my direction has been guided by a wonderful discovery from last week that was made in the boiler room, the place that I am now standing. As we were cleaning in the boiler room last week, we found a cornerstone. It was not just any cornerstone, but it was the one laid at Crawford Street Methodist Episcopal Church South in 1899. If you look at some of the old pictures of that church, the one that stood from 1900 until 1925, it appears to even show what we think is the cornerstone that we discover. Of course, many of you know that this church building was destroyed by fire, and the cornerstone was apparently preserved. And at some point, it ended up in the boiler room here at Crawford Street in the new building that was constructed after. It was tucked away under a bunch of other stuff. And now, here it is. Now, the thing about this cornerstone is this. It hasn't deteriorated at all. It's a bit dusty and it's quite dirty, but it's still just as solid, I suspect, as it was in 1899 when it was put in place. And if you want proof of that, come on up here and try and lift it. This thing is really heavy. In this season of COVID-19, with our social distancing, with our inability to gather together and worship in the same place, the discovery of this cornerstone has seemed especially poignant to me. And I say that because we didn't even know this was here. It was tucked away out of sight, just gathering dust, getting dirty, having more stuff piled upon it. Yet here it is now, as strong as ever before. Okay, I know this one probably preaches itself, right? You know where I'm heading with this, I suspect. And that's okay. I'm glad you're with me. I'm glad you're maybe even a step or two ahead of me, because we should know this one. We should get this one. For we are followers of the risen Christ. And we know that He is the cornerstone of our faith. We know that He is the cornerstone of our life. Scripture reminds us of that time and time again. We heard it already from the psalmist and from St. Matthew. Mark and Luke in their Gospels, also in the telling of the parable of the wicked tenants, share these same words. The stone that the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. We see it in the book of Acts, again with Peter and John before the council, and Peter saying, "The stone that was rejected by you, the builders, it has become the cornerstone." You reach back all the way to the prophet Isaiah, and there he speaks these words, "See, I am laying in Zion a foundation stone, a tested stone, a precious stone, a sure foundation." And all of these words are echoed in 1 Peter, where we read, "See, I am laying in Zion a stone, a cornerstone, chosen and precious, and whoever believes in him will not be put to shame. To you then who believe, he is precious. But for those who do not believe, the stone that the builders rejected has become the very head of the corner." So yes, Jesus is the cornerstone. Yet in finding this cornerstone in the boiler room, I was reminded of what we sometimes may do with the cornerstone of our faith and lives. Sometimes we might just let that truth get a little dusty. Sometimes we may even try and hide it away when it's not very convenient for what's going on in our lives at that moment. But you know what? The truth is, it's not going anywhere. Jesus is not going anywhere. Jesus is with us always. Our cornerstone, our firm foundation. So on this day, we celebrate the discovery of an old cornerstone found in the boiler room of a great old church. And on this day, we celebrate and we give thanks for the cornerstone in our lives that is Jesus, and how firm a foundation that truly is. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. thanks be to God that Jesus Christ is our firm foundation. May our Lord Jesus bless you and keep you now and all your days. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.